This video is based on the hybrid metaheuristics. In this video, we will try to understand hybrid grasshopper optimization algorithm with genetic algorithm. We will try to understand how we can combine two metaheuristics to solve optimization problems. As you can see here, we have hybrid grasshopper optimization algorithm with genetic algorithm. In this algorithm, author combined two metaheuristics to solve optimization problems. Here you can see we have two metaheuristics, grasshopper optimization algorithm and genetic algorithm. So author combined the merits of these two algorithms to solve the system of nonlinear equations. As we know, according to No-Freelands theorem, there is no universal better algorithm that can solve all type of optimization problems alone. Hybrid metaheuristics are used to overcome different challenges that we will discuss in the upcoming slides. Here you can see we have hybrid metaheuristics further divided into two types, low-level hybridization and high-level hybridization. Suppose we have two algorithms, algorithm A and algorithm B, and as we know that each algorithm has their own merits and demerits. Now suppose we combine the merits of these two algorithms. So here we combine the merits of algorithm A with the merits of algorithm B, and we have new algorithm, that is hybrid AB algorithm. Now this new algorithm is better as compared to algorithm A or as compared to algorithm B. As we combine the merits of these two algorithms, now this algorithm is powerful as compared to these two algorithms, as we will obtain better and accurate results. In the hybrid metaheuristics, we combine the merits of two metaheuristic algorithms to solve optimization problems. Basic details about hybrid metaheuristics we already discussed in this video. For more details, you can check this video. Link is given below in the description or in the comments. Right now in this video, we will try to understand the hybridization of grasshopper optimization algorithm with genetic algorithm. For basic details about hybrid metaheuristics, you can check this video. Now you can see here we have different types of metaheuristics. We can combine metaheuristics with metaheuristics, or we can combine metaheuristics with exact methods, or we can combine metaheuristics with artificial intelligence, or we can combine metaheuristics with machine learning or data mining techniques. Right now in this video, we will combine two metaheuristics, that is grasshopper optimization algorithm and genetic algorithm. So here we have genetic algorithm and grasshopper optimization algorithm. As in this video, we will try to understand the hybrid grasshopper optimization algorithm with genetic algorithm. We will discuss the hybridization process. For basic details about grasshopper optimization algorithm and genetic algorithm, you can check this video and this one. Here you can see the mathematical models, position update and other activities. Right now in this video, we will focus on the hybridization. For more details, you can check these videos. Now you can see here we have metaheuristic with metaheuristic. We have two metaheuristic algorithms, grasshopper optimization algorithm and genetic algorithm. Now we will combine two metaheuristic algorithms to solve the optimization problem. So first we will try to understand how we can combine two metaheuristics. Here we have hybrid grasshopper optimization algorithm with genetic algorithm, that is the combination of two metaheuristics, GOA and genetic algorithm. Done. Now first we will recap the basic key points about metaheuristics. As we know, in the population-based metaheuristics, we have two important phases, exploration phase and exploitation phase, that is global search and local search. Exploration phase is also known as global search, and exploitation phase is also known as local search. In the exploration phase, all the search agents will move in the search space and they will try to find out the optimal solution globally. And in the exploitation phase, all the search agents will converge at a point that is the optimal point. In the population-based metaheuristic, these are very important phases. Now, problem is population-based metaheuristic algorithms easily converge. It means they easily stuck in the local optima. And once the algorithm is stuck in the local optima, it cannot find out the optimal solution globally. So this is the first challenge. Another challenge you can see here, high computational cost parameters. Sometimes we have large number of parameters, design variables, optimal solution. Even sometimes we have large search space. So in the large search space, how we can find out the optimal solution? So here you can see we have different types of challenges in the metaheuristics. Now we introduce the concept of hybrid metaheuristics to overcome such challenges. So as algorithm trapped in the local optima, it cannot find out the optimal solution globally. To overcome such problems or challenges, hybrid metaheuristic algorithms are used, where we can combine two metaheuristics. And hybrid metaheuristics can manage large search space, large number of design variables, parameters, and computational cost. Also, hybrid metaheuristics also prevent algorithm to stuck in the local optima that we will discuss in the upcoming slide. So here we have hybrid grasshopper optimization algorithm with the genetic algorithm. As you know, in the population-based algorithm, we have two important phases, global search, local search, that is the exploration phase and the exploitation phase. So here we have two metaheuristics, grasshopper and genetic. We will use the exploration phase from grasshopper optimization algorithm, that is the global search from. So we will use the global search process from grasshopper optimization algorithm, and local search, that is exploitation phase, from genetic algorithm. As you can see here, we have operators in the genetic algorithm: selection, mutation, crossover, evaluation, and other. These operators prevent algorithm to stuck in the local optima. So here we have hybrid grasshopper optimization algorithm, where we combined the merits of grasshopper algorithm with the genetic algorithm. As metaheuristic algorithms easily trapped in the local optima, so here we are using the genetic algorithm with the grasshopper optimization algorithm. These operators will prevent this algorithm to trap in the local optima. Right now you can see we have certain steps used in this algorithm. First, we will initialize all the important parameters for grasshopper optimization algorithm and genetic algorithm. After that, we will initialize the population for the n individuals in the search space randomly. After that, using any objective function, or you can say fitness function, we will evaluate the performance for each agent in the search space. Now you can see, using objective function, we evaluated their performance. Now we can easily select the best among all, that is the agent having minimum value, and that is the target. We select the best agent among all, and all agents will update their position in the search space according to the position of the best search agents. They will update their position around the best agents. Now step 5, we will update the position for the agents. Now here we are updating the position. It means we have the exploration phase, it means they are moving in the search space. So here we are using the grasshopper optimization algorithm to update the agent's position, that is the exploration phase. Now agents will explore the search space and after that they will find out the optimal solution. So here we are using the grasshopper optimization algorithm position update, that is the exploration phase, to update agent's position, and this is the mathematical equation that we can use to update agent's position. Here this is the new position xi, I is the number of individuals in the search space, d means total number of design variables, and this is the lower bound and upper bound. And here we can see this is the distance between two grasshopper, and here this is the best search agent. So using this equation we can update the position for n agents in the search space. After that, once the position is updated, we will evaluate the performance again using objective function, and once the performance evaluation is done, again we will find out the best agent, that is the target. After that we will evaluate the solution using genetic algorithm. So here you can see we have step 8. Here we will evaluate the solution using genetic algorithm. Now here you can see in the genetic algorithm we have different operators. First we will perform the selection. Here we will perform the tournament selection that is used for agent selection. After that we have crossover process. During this process, two children solution are generated from two parent solution, and then we have mutation where we will replace their parent and form parent for the next iteration, and then we will update their fitness values and position, and then we will update their position and fitness values. After that we will update the best solution using the genetic algorithm. We will update the best solution, that is the target solution, and then we will check the stopping criteria. Stopping criteria means we will check whether the current iteration is less than or equal to maximum number of iteration or not. If the stopping criteria is met, then stop and display the best solution, that is the optimal solution found. If stopping criteria is not met, then we will repeat this loop from step 4 to step 9. So here you can see this is the hybridization process. Here we combine the merits of two meta heuristics to solve the optimization problem. So in this video we try to understand how we can combine two meta heuristics. We can combine the exploration phase with the excitation phase of another algorithm. It means we will combine the merits of one algorithm with the merit of another algorithm to solve the optimization problem. So that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.